Hello, I'm Addie Shaney. Welcome to the latest installment of Atherton On Air NTI Edition. Here's what's trending. The date is set for Atherton's virtual graduation ceremony. It will be Tuesday, May 26th at 9 a.m. This event will also be recorded if you want to watch at a different time. Every graduate will be recognized by name in this virtual ceremony. On Friday, May 22nd, seniors can report to campus while remaining in their vehicles to pick up their cap and gown. You must enter through the student parking lot during your assigned time frame. We have those listed on the screen. There are a lot of rules to follow to make sure this event is safe. Dr. Aberle has released all those rules to Atherton families via email and social media. Please read over that information very carefully. Everyone must follow these rules to comply with state and local guidelines. In other news, life is slowly returning to a new normal with some businesses and medical offices reopening in Kentucky, but it looks a lot differently these days. For example, just going to the dentist is a whole new experience. Atherton On Air reporter Amy Codwell with the story.
We are a little busier right now because we are getting so many patients in that were scheduled those weeks that we were closed. We're a lot busier because of that.
Patients that were hesitant. They just said they were not ready to come back. They didn't feel comfortable about being out again. Most of those patients did have underlying health conditions that made them apprehensive about coming in. And then a few patients are older, so they wanted to stay inside a little longer too. But not many. So we are very busy right now just rescheduling. So we had 6 weeks that we were away. We have to reschedule all those patients. So we've been very busy, so, and grateful that we're busy.
In our office, Dr. Harris hired, or didn't hire, but asked us all to come back full time. So we were all very pleased that we had jobs to come back to. And we're a close-knit type family here. So it was good to see everybody again and to work with everybody again.
Different, but we got it done.
I was excited to see my work colleagues and talk to people again other than my kids and wife. I'm definitely tired today because getting back in the routine of walking so much and seeing so many patients during the day, definitely getting back in the swing of things. Whereas opposed, we used to have three or four in the waiting room. Patients aren't checking out in the normal checkout area anymore. They're going straight out through the waiting room and the clinical staff are trying to take the payments up front and all that stuff. We are spraying the rooms down about three times more than we used to.
One activity that you can do at home is work on your baking skills. In today's show, we take you into the kitchen of Kaden Mulrooney for a sweet surprise. Kaden?
Thanks, Addie. Today I'm here in my kitchen and we're gonna be making some really good vanilla cupcakes to give out to my friends as a little pick-me-up gift during quarantine. So without further ado, let's get started.
Thank you. Swanson was one of the Atherton students selected for the Governor's School for the Arts. She has a great eye for capturing beautiful photos and video. Here's what she's working on this week.
Quarantine can be really hard, and it can definitely take a toll on your mental health if you're sitting in your room all day. So maybe next week, choose to go outside, take a bike ride with your family, or go on a walk with your sister. Make sure you take time for yourself. You need it. Don't make it up there too often. High beams on, it starts to pour. Radio loud, 84. Got the crew back together. It feels like it's been forever. But after a drink, they left the bar. Watch it expand, they know how we are. Thanks, Rhiannon. Back by popular demand, it's time for another edition of Animals of Atherton. Let's check in with Hannah Harper for that.
Thanks, Addie. Our pets are helping us all feel the love during these crazy times. French teacher Miss Watkins sent us these photos of her two fur babies. The little guy is Jasper and her other dog is Finley. And then we have this photo sent to us from Joseph Guthrie. He's also the proud owner of two dogs. These are Joseph and Patty. Of course, dogs aren't the only pets who are keeping us entertained during quarantine. Atherton Media student Sean Hall introduces us to his new friend.
Hey, what's up, Atherton On Air? It's me, Sean, and I'm back for another quarantine video. So, while quarantine is going on, I can't really go out as much. I need more company at home. So, I decided to get a new little buddy.
This here is Tobias. He's my new bearded dragon. Just a baby, but I've had him for maybe about a week now. Tobias is really chill. This is Tobias's enclosure. We have a whole den over here, but he's chilling on top of it, as you can see, not chilling inside, but whenever he sleeps, he can go in there if it's too bright out. He likes dark whenever he sleeps, like most people. So here we have the hammock. He likes to chill and bask with these two lights here. This is for UVB. And this is for heat. He likes to open his mouth and bask in the light sometimes, just absorb it, because he's cold-blooded and can't get his heat normally like we can. And we have just a little pathway up, a little branch. He has a food bowl. He took a big poopy earlier today. I just cleaned it up. He has a water bowl. Yeah, he's a happy little dragon. Right here we got Tobias's food. I gotta shake him up in a little baggie with some calcium powder in it so little Tobias can get some more calcium and grow big and strong. I know Tobias is a hungry boy, so here we got him his food. Hope you guys enjoyed the video of my new little buddy. Welcome to the family, Tobias.
Thanks, Sean. Tobias is quite the pet. If you would like to share your favorite animal friend with us, please send a photo and a brief description to Miss MacArthur. Her email is on the screen. Back to you, Addie.
Thanks, Hannah. Music is also keeping us all sane these days. Here's our music expert, Kaden Eli, with another artist you might want to check out.
Hi, I'm Kay Neely with another edition of Album of the Week. This week's new band is Sonic Youth. Sonic Youth was a New York-based band formed in 1981 with founding members Kim Gordon, Thurston Moore, Lee Rinaldo, and Steve Shelley, following another series of short-term drummers. Their sixth studio album, Goo, is a personal favorite of mine. An album so full of energy and positivity, it's a must-listen to in these times. Throughout the album, themes of female empowerment and pop culture seem to show up through Kim Gordon's expressive lyrics and pivotal force on the alternative rock world. Let's have a listen.
Thanks, Kaden. With only one more week of NTI left, let's wrap up the show with a few messages from Atherton students. Here's what they had to say about topics ranging from their quarantine coping skills, their favorite NTI teachers, and what they miss about real school.
My name is Abigail O'Connor, and I am a senior, and today I wanted to talk about how I've been coping with quarantine. I'm as good-natured as possible. I haven't been coping quite well, but I've been doing my best. And it's, to put it as short and simple as possible, being locked up like this isn't exactly fantastic. Mental health is not good. Creativity is not good. But I'm sure I'm not the only one who's going to be talking about this. That and I'm a senior, missing out on everything at the end of the year. But I'm sure it'll be fine very soon.
Hi, my name is Alex and I'm a sophomore, and today I'm here to share my thoughts about what I miss and don't miss about being in school. For starters, I really miss being able to see my friends and hanging with them either before or after class. Also after school, where we would all chill in the concourse and wait for our rides. Another thing I miss from school are some school events, such as the football games, basketball games, volleyball games, etc. A couple of things I don't miss about school are the tests and quizzes. I'm really glad we don't have any of those anymore. I also don't miss having homework every day. With NTI, it's just one assignment from every class, and you have the whole week to finish it, which is a lot less stressful. Basically, school has its ups and downs. Thanks for listening.
I hope you're doing good. I'm just living the quarantine life here, and I hope all you seniors out there are having fun no matter what, because your year got cut off, and you need to be having fun doing whatever you're doing, because it's your senior year still, quarantine or not. But me, I've just been cutting all kinds of grass, and I've been trying to make that money because I haven't been at work, and I've been cleaning up the Red Beauty van down there. See if you can see her. Yeah, brother, she's been getting almost brand new. She's looking nice, but I've also been getting the boat ready for lake season, because this weather, as soon as it warms up, lake season's full. It's coming on in full force, and we're going to be out there every weekend. Hope you guys are doing good. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Jaden, and I am a sophomore at Atherton High School. I'd like to address how I am personally spending my time and coping during this quarantine. First thing is, how am I spending my time? Well, the best way you can really spend your time is doing something without many people around, or doing something at home. I like to go hiking with the family, or sometimes I'll go kayaking, since you don't really have to get close to people during that, and you can actively distance yourself. At home, I like to commonly play music, listen to music. Sometimes I'll play games on my computer and read as well. And of course, staying in contact with friends is important, and for that I use Discord, video call, and voice call. I hope you guys are doing good, and I hope you have a great week. Thank you.
Hi, my name's Jess. I'm a sophomore, and I'm going to be talking about a teacher that I think deserves some appreciation. My geometry teacher, Mr. Mulberger, over the weeks of NTI has uploaded every assignment on time. He grades them fast and accurate. There's never any grading errors. He gives clear instructions by uploading videos of himself explaining the assignments and how to do them with examples so that no one is left behind. And he takes time out of his day every week to do Zoom calls and just lets everyone have an opportunity to ask questions if they're confused, to get everything all cleared up. So, thank you for listening.
Hi, I'm Mila and I'm a sophomore, and I just wanted to give a quick shout out to the Atherton teachers who are working so hard to keep our education consistent and interesting. While this pandemic can be really off-putting and scary, it's good to have our educators keeping us focused, in the loop, and excited to learn during this difficult time. This is an adjustment for everyone, one that would be so much harder to make without the teachers' constant support. So, once again, thank you, Atherton teachers, for your time and effort. We don't know what we would do without you.
Thanks to students in Ms. MacArthur's communication class for sharing those messages. That's all the time we have for now. Let's end the show with some calming views of nature, captured by freshman Sterling Hoffman. And remember, what you do makes a difference.